Dutch Prodigy, they just need to win this one to at least give them a shot as well. But let's see. It's a Mirage. They're up against the Untouchables. Untouchables,
of course,
actually
it's Mirage.
Not having a win yet, so they
are Untouchables still on zero?
They have a draw, so they have all the motivation to win one, right? At least one.
Yeah, well, they should anyway. And like you said, battle for the fourth place, but not exactly in this match because the Untouchables, not very reasonable chances for them to still make it to the arena. Actually, no chances at all. But them winning this match could have very big implications for who does get that fourth spot. The first three are basically decided now, as they will be Lowland Lions and Asterion and then Venko in that order. And fourth place can either be Dutch Prodigy, MCON, or Triple Play, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so that still hangs in the balance as the knife round is concluded. We have the Untouchables actually winning the knife round. They have nothing to lose throughout this map. Everything is on Dutch Prodigy. They need to win if they want to secure the fourth spot for themselves. And even so, it might not happen. So we're in it. Rix, please, take it away.
All right, looks like Dutch Prodigy are looking to go for that A approach. And Mikey, you actually find up a deal. This might be a little bit of a cheeky thing. Clash up on Palace with just a block to hand. Looks like Mikey immediately being dropped by Koze as soon as he showed himself. And now the smokes are going to come in. And finally, Dutch Prodigy are going to commence this assault. Realizer taken out of Impress. There's only three players left up alive. This bomb might actually go down, and Koze looking to stop that. Does do a lot of damage though, and he's kind of walking around in the middle of the map, and Koze picking himself up the three men, in fact, and Taslak downing the last player. And there's Koze to go for that, the bomb defuse as well. That would be actually the first round for the Untouchables.
Okay, so good start by them, and I'm not sure what that deagle on Mikey was. I'm pretty sure that he got it dropped from someone so that he did have armor behind that. A bit of a tank mode going in there, but with the pistols on the... Well, pistols in general in CSGO, you don't need the deagle on pistol rounds. No one can afford head armor, therefore a Tech 9 or a P50 even at most ranges will be good enough for that one-shot headshot. Like you saw, he got taken down by a one-shot headshot by a USP, even the starter pistol for the CTs. Of course, Ts don't really have that luxury, but Deagle is a very big investment that isn't particularly necessary, in my opinion. And it didn't work out, unfortunately, for them. However, they do have a little bit of a smoke execute ready for this A site that might result in a bomb plant.
Yeah, if only they can flush out Realizer, because he's there with the SMG. He's got himself support of Koze with the assault rifle as well. So looking at both of these players, ooh, Clash actually downing Realizer. He didn't fire off a single shot, and this bomb might actually just go down, and will. Mikey connecting the second one for Dutch Prodigy as Koze goes down 3-on-3. Scandalous does mop up. Cobus nearly connecting himself to the second one as well. Molly comes out. Mitchell will go down. It's going to be down to Mikey. Okay. Nearly downing Taslak. Oh, actually picking up that frag of the A-cat. But Taslak does close out that round. But a lot of damage being done by Dutch Prodigy. Three frags and the bomb plant. That is quite sensational with just Glocks.
Yeah, well, Mike, you couldn't make it happen with the deagle in the previous round, so he had the feeling that he had to step up quite a little bit, I imagine. Picks up two frags for his team with very little investment, like you say. They did manage to get that bomb plant, which helps them out a lot, and that's actually the reason that they are able to go for a full buy-up now rather than in the next round. And it seems like the Untouchables are anticipating that. Full rifles on them. No more SMG play coming out there. They just want to make sure that they pick up this round as well and see how far they can get. Go out with their heads high, because like we mentioned before, they're definitely not making it into the arena anymore.
Yeah, it looks like Dutch Prodigy are going to go for that slow-paced approach, as they want to claim that first round. Taslak on an op though, looking towards middle, but there's no one going to be there. And quite surprisingly, Dutch Prodigy, they don't fancy really taking in mid control. You do have Mikey watching any sort of mid approaches. Cobus being tagged up through the wall, but will obviously survive that. Realizer just below the palace, and there's Koze as well.
Right, so looks like maybe this A play is finally going to come in with the little bit more than a minute left on the clock. They have that lurker all the way over towards that B site, getting so much information, but not faking all that much out. Doesn't matter, however, as they're charging out of the A site, they do actually get pull frags, but they lose two more members in the process. 2 versus 3 now, favoring the Untouchables on this retake, but that op could get a bit awkward there as he picks up a frag onto Mitchell. Only MyQ left alive. He's gotten quite some frags before with this Glock. Maybe now with an AK in hands, he'll be able to do even more.
Well, there's no answer.
Yeah, he was not able to do more, is the answer. Maybe next time he should switch to his Glock. No? Not a good idea?
Nah.
Anyway, the Untouchables pick up the first buy round. Dash Prodigy was able to get it in there a little bit quicker than usual because of that extra bomb plant they managed to get. And, well, the Untouchables, they were equipped for it. They managed to keep them down, and they do actually have a proper full buy-up now. Last round, they still had someone on a pistol. They managed to claim that fifth man's rifle. I'm not sure if they picked up that op or bought it, but either way, they have one. And Dutch Prodigy, they just want to get another bomb plant, I think, over towards the B side, it seems. And the first man goes down to AKIT. The second man goes down thanks to AKIT, but dies to by himself. And not looking all that bright so far.
Yeah, and also a grenade coming from Dutch Prodigy and damaging their own guys. That's not a particularly great start. Despite that, they do manage to get a kill in as their AKIT. And it looks like they are going to collect themselves. Oh, Taslak just looking at Ray at the wrong time. They might actually just make a rotation if they go fast towards the A bomb site, but they need to leg it. Run as fast as they can and probably take out that. Gonna have to take out Realizer as he's watching towards the cross. Actually, he's repositioning himself towards window. And really, Dutch Prodigy, there's always these teams that they slow down on these rotations when I think it's not really worth it. Sometimes you just need to go bomb it out and
But look how well it's working. They're only Realizer so far away in this A site, and there's two members still in middle for some reason. Middle control isn't all that relevant anymore this deep into the round, and as a result of that, Dutch Prodigy have a window of opportunity to make it into the site. Imprez even managing to pick up a frag despite MyQ going down. Peek's a little bit too enthusiastic and does get taken down as well, but Clash is still on and around this site. Picks up one more frag with his Tech 9. Only two more members left to find, one of which is low HP. And dinks up the other one, actually. Manages to pick him up as well. Only Koze left alive with 13 HP versus the 6 that Clash still has. 10 seconds on this clock. And if he doesn't wallbang too enthusiastically, this bomb should go down.
Yeah, now Clash on the verge of a fantastic round. This both players incredibly low, but looks like Koze is going to wallbang him there in the end.
Yeah, I'm a bit curious why he didn't do that while he was planting the bomb, because he was so low that one bullet would have been enough. Either way, the wallbang is what killed him in the end, and it was a very nice attempt by Clash, but it didn't really work out well enough. However, it was an eco, so they got a very good result out of it, considering that, and they're forcing the Untouchables onto an almost total rebuy, barring the op that they did manage to save, AKIT that was. And, well, they just got a full rifle buy-up. They got plenty of utility now on the Dutch Prodigy side, and they're splitting up a little bit, but it looks as if they might want to go for a bit of an A split here, as there's actually a lot of aggression from the Untouchables on short. Gonna peek it from here, not really bothering to take middle from the sniper's nest. And in the meantime, Taslak manages to pick up that frag onto Kobus, who's been relatively quiet throughout this series, actually.
Wow, okay. Koze pushing down the Pellas, taking out one, and Mitchell and both Kobus are both down and out. A Clash, though, again, the only man to deliver so far. MyQ does follow up onto his footsteps as he takes out Realizer, and surely Dutch Prodigy aren't going to be able to plant that bomb as CT is now being smoked off. Looks like we'll have a 3-on-3 after plant as Impress, Spot, Scandalous, AKIT will down Clash, and now it looks to be in a bit of a pickle here as Impress does deliver, taking out two kills. Taslak, though, chiming back with a kill onto Impress. 1-on-1, MyQ versus Taslak, as Taslak approaches the bomb side. He's looking all sorts of angles as he's gonna look to actually go for a defuse and actually fake that out there. And MyQ with the Glock out, he's learned it, but does pull out his AK in the end to take out Taslak. And there's the first round on the board for Dutch Prodigy finally coming in there.
I'm not sure if you saw, but Taslak actually tried to go for a no scope there. Not sure if that was an impulse or just or just cool, but not very effective either way. And Clash now, as a result of that, has an op back in his hands to work with. And MyQ just going very, very aggressively out on this A side, manages to pick up the first frag onto Tazlak, and they're just going to snowball onto the site, despite the fact that there were four members there, three of them already down, and MyQ claimed all three of them.
Yeah, and interestingly enough, like, the Untouchables have been taking four rounds in a row, but their economy was just terrible throughout. And, well, you know, how can I get cleaned up? Seems to be like a kit. Little bit unlucky there, as he did drop by impressed to 2 HP, but will get cleaned up in the end there. Solid round from Dutch Prodigy, not losing a single member. And it is 4-2 now, and again, the Untouchables not too much of an economy, and looks like they are not going to be buying up. They're just going to go for those CZs, deagles, have a 5-7 as well, a couple of grenades, and a smoke onto Realizer.
Yeah, so very poor buy, like you point out, and it almost looked like this Prodigy wanted to just go aggressively again into this A site while there's again a little bit of a stack going on, and because they got that first strike, they wanted to continue. Realizer managed to find one in return, but Impress and Mitchell chime in together to pick up three, and MyQ finishes it off, picks up the last member, and up until this round, Mitchell was actually on minus one frag still. Like, he had the one suicide in the pistol round or the round after, and ever okay. since hadn't been able to get anything done, so just got his first kill of the game, and now he's on 0-5. So, you know, it's MyQ and Impress pulling a lot of the weight for Dutch Prodigy, but either way, as long as they're getting rounds on the board, I suppose that doesn't matter all that much. And on the Untouchable side, I'm not sure who's going to be carrying the weight now, because it feels like Dutch Prodigy are starting to wake up more and more, and once they're warm, once they start hitting shots, like Mitchell just did on the Scandalous, that can get very hot. But luckily, Tazlak is still around, picks up that return, but Impress, also one of the members for his team who had been performing so far and is looking to fight their way into the Amsterdam Arena.
Looks like Clash was opting to molly that position of A-Kid. Another molly coming out. A-Kid is under loads of pressure on that B-bomb side as he checks out a molly by himself, but MyQ timing that one perfectly and takes him out 2-3 for the Untouchables. And Koze close by on the B-bomb side, but there's Clash as well, knows exactly where he is as Tazlak approaches it as well. Will go down to MyQ. MyQ delivering with his AK, and Koze actually by himself will go down to Clash, and just like that, we're even Stevens.
Yeah, for now, but the economy on the Untouchables isn't really allowing them to put much of a foot between the door to try and get something out of this round. It looks like they're going to have to go for yet another eco, and on the opposite side, we have MyQ and Clash both like well above 10k after buying up, after getting whatever they wanted, so oof. Koze with a very nice 1D to start off the round, with Clash rips his off head off in turn, and this is looking like another blood map on the A site.
Yeah, well, it's going tip for tap, though, but it's now Tazlak 1 versus 2, MyQ and Clash, but looks like Clash is just going to run like forest towards that bomb side, and MyQ will be able to cut off any sort of rotation from Tazlak, so he's going to be completely safe. It's just going to be a matter of time for Tazlak to realize what the deuce is going on here, and MyQ kind of spack him as Tazlak makes his rotation. MyQ not going to be able to connect that shot, but it is an information gained by him. Clash will plant the bomb and look towards an angle. And there we go. Tazlak goes down, and it's 5-4. Dutch Prodigy in the lead.
So he didn't only run like Forrest, he also managed to land that shot like Forrest. And in my opinion, that's a much bigger compliment. And, well, that does level things out nicely again, as those two ecos give the Untouchables a little bit more financial room to work with. Another full buy by them, plenty of utility this time, and they finally have an op on Tazlak again, seeing if that's going to be something that they can use to break open, or break rather, the attacks that Dutch Prodigy have been throwing at them. But so far it looks like the utility is being used very, very well by them to gain a lot of ground. Scandalous finds that frag on a Mitchell and the follow-up onto Kobus as well. And Impress luckily manages to get a refrag on the A site, but the bomb still headed towards the B site, and Kobus more of a distraction here than an actual attack. But of course, the Untouchables don't know that, and they have started a rotation.
Oh,
and actually,
man.
He managed to find another frag, so I did not, but it does call the last member to rotate finally, and Tazlak finds that frag, but they don't immediately know that there's not going to be an A hit until Tazlak starts to get curious towards the underpass, actually. The gig is up. They have to get this site now before it's too late, and it could still get very, very close.
Wow. Clash going down there with the bomb. That's not what Mikey needs right now. Is he does manage to take out A-Kit. Scandalous. Just around that corner. As Tazlak makes his way forward, he knows exactly where the bomb is. In fact, he's standing right on it. And now Mikey, what can he do? Checks out a molly. That Kuta calls for a little bit of a distraction, but Tazlak will take him out there. And I don't know. Just to make a mark about Impress, like, Realizer, he was coming around the corner from Palace, and he had all the time in the world to take out Impress, but he missed every single shot, and then Impress just took him out.
Who is Realizer? Because I don't think we've seen him so far. Maybe he's someone who changed his name, but...
No, we have.
I don't think we've seen him. Anyway, Tazlak picked up the early advantage. That's nice for them to start with, and in the last round, I think the biggest problem that we saw for... Dutch Prodigy was them being too passive on that B take, because that A fake by Impress, that worked perfectly, especially because he picked up two frags off the back of it, and they didn't capitalize on it quick enough. They were too hesitant. Clash was still holding the back instead of going for the bomb plant, and the Untouchables were able to recover. So in this round, man advantage going in the favor of the Untouchables, only four men left alive for Dutch Prodigy, and it looks like they're going to be hitting the A site together with those four people.
Yeah, it's going to be Realizer out there as he checks down a smoke grenade, and Clash actually just making his way forward, and Realizer could just out time, and Kozé's there nearby as well as Impress does manage to take out Tazlak. That is an AWPer gone, 4-4. Realizer will go down immediately, execution style. Mitchell takes out another one as Kozé down and out, and Mitchell going to go ahead and plant that bomb. Scandalous and A-Kit with it all to do. Looks like they are going to be opting for that save as well. And Dutch Prodigy, they're kind of hungry for them, you know. They want to break the economy of the Untouchables. They're looking for those frags. Cobus charging in from the B apps. You have got Clash coming in as well. He's actually pushing down with an AWP as well. And looking to coordinate this with Cobus. Oh, Cobus right. Actually taken out too right there. And well, that is great for Dutch Prodigy.
Yeah, that was a very nice... transition from Cobus picking up both those frags, and that's making it more and more awkward now for the Untouchables. Their money not in a very good place, and their rounds aren't either. Sixth round has been claimed for Dutch Prodigy. They've got a very nice amount to end the half on, theoretically, and they're up against the full eco almost out of the Untouchables. Clash is just holding house on A, picks up two frags, and everyone else is nowhere near to be found.
Yeah, and again, Dutch Prodigy find themselves on A side. Nicely opened up, courtesy of Clash and Mikey and Impress clean up the rest. It's scandalous. It's just the USB. Does actually take out Impress, but that's gonna be about it. 7-5, Dutch Prodigy now leading by two rounds.
Still with such a low economy on the Untouchables, CT side is the more expensive side, and you can see that it's really, really hurting the Untouchables to, well, first of all, lose so many rounds, but also the one that they won in between that reset the round loss bonus, not doing anything nice for them, and it's really, really putting them at a very big disadvantage in this half. They even have a UMP now versus a proper full buy out of Dutch Prodigy. Proper bank still saved up on them, and look at this map control. They're not even bothering for B anymore. They pushed up short, and it seems like they don't. Yeah, but they pushed up short, and it seems like they don't anticipate B. Actually, he is going to be holding this in case they fall back. And finally, Scandalous is rotating back towards this B site, so they have a little bit of control. But him by himself might not be able to get all that much done, as he does get taken down there. But in the meantime, on the opposite side of the map, we do have two kills going in favor of the CTs. However, B site has been claimed, and this is going to come down to the retake.
Yeah, and Dutch Prodigy, they are not just going to allow this this retake that easily. They still have some utility in hands of Impress as well. Mike Yu is trying to hold up these CT players for a very long time. Did spot Tazlak out there as well. Tazlak does manage to take him out, but Mitchell will take him out as well. So nice crossfire setup. It is down to Realizer with the ump, and looks like he's just going to go for that save yet again. But the T's, they got plenty of money. They are going to try and run him down. Impress actually deciding to back off right now, and it will be 8-5. That's already a very impressive scoreline on their terrorist side.
Yeah, but to be fair, this is a team that has a very good chance at still qualifying for the LAN, for the finals of our league. And the Untouchables are pretty much already out. And, you know, just playing this for the experience likely, or to finish the tournament, you know, be a good sport, because them qualifying is absolutely impossible at this point in the tournament. And, well, like you pointed out, all the way at the start of the cast, Dutch Prodigy, they have all motivation to win this.
Yeah, and they need this win as well in order to get themselves on that fourth place, and looks like they are going to do it now beautifully, as Mitchell with two, Mikey with one as well. And again, that A-bomb side completely open. We do have Realizer though, bit of a surprise, taking out Impress, but that bomb will still get planted regardless of that fact as well. No, it's still not planted. There we go. Realizer, your last man standing.
Yeah, might just want to be holding on to this. They don't actually have that much money. And as he decides to run away and hold on to that AK, Mike Q doesn't want him to, chucks in a nade and picks up a frag. And is that knife, what is that called, Brightwater? I've only seen that as an M4 skin. I have no idea what the skins are they're adding nowadays. But anyway, still have an op on the CT's last round of the half here. Dutch Prodigy, 9 rounds up against the 5 of the Untouchables. And it looks like they just want to get out here quick. Tazlak finds the first frag onto Clash, gets some heavy fire afterwards, gets taken down by Mike Q, and Kobus finds another frag onto Realizer. We only have Kose left in the jungle area, and Akid actually pushing up close now from the stairs, but the bomb has gone down, and we're in a retake situation.
Yeah, it's a 2-on-3, and slowly but surely, the Untouchables are going to creep their way forward, and Mike Q standing here close. Let's take out some damage from a grenade, and Mitchell now coming in as well. There we go. Mitchell and Mike Q doing absolute great work. Mike Q to close out the round right there. It's 10-5 for the Dutch Prodigy.
Yeah, that is quite a good half on your T side. 10 rounds, not bad at all. This basically means that if the Untouchables want to have a chance of making it back into this map, if they want to have a chance at upsetting Dutch Prodigy and perhaps preventing their chances from qualifying for the LAN finals, then they really have to pick up this pistol round and step up in the following ones. But to be honest, the way Mike Q has been playing, the way Impress and Clash both have been performing, I don't assume those chances to be very likely. Dutch Prodigy, they've deserved this in my opinion, and I think that they'll be able to clutch this out rather comfortably. However, it's not been Kobus, who is usually one of the big fraggers for them, who's been stepping up. It's really, well, the triple that I just mentioned, Mike Q, Impress, and Clash.
Yeah, I mean, they do switch around a couple of times. Sometimes it's Clash top fragging by a mile, and the other time you have Mike Q doing weird ninja defuses. So we might actually see them again.
The ninja defuses, yeah, I do hope so. Like, it's a fun little thing for Mike Q to bring to the table in the Benelux scene, and well, it's worked out more than once, so that's something that I really like about it as well. But anyway, it looks like we are into the next pistol round here, ladies and gentlemen. Second half of the Untouchables versus Dutch Prodigy here on Mirage. It is 10-5 favoring Dutch Prodigy on the most favored side of the map now, and this is going to be a very exciting pistol round because it's going to decide oh so much.
In DDO. Very, very slow play from the Untouchables. They're kind of just collecting themselves. AKit kind of looking in the middle of nowhere. And, well, looks like they are attempting to go towards that A-bomb site. They do have a couple of decoys, but Mike Q, he knows what's up. He spots there's actually nothing out there on towards those B-apps, so surely Dutch Prodigy are going to be ready.
But that attention in middle did really help, because they were a little bit distracted, but Kobus has made his way back to the site, and they're seemingly charging into A now. Kobus picks up the first strike, drops the bomb, but Akid finds one in return, and some more CTs have arrived to the party. Pick up some more frags, but Tazlak with two, definitely not out of this yet. 2 versus 2 now, as the bomb is yet to go down.
Yeah, Mikey now is going to have to make up for this one. But not gonna happen. Impress will do so. Gonna have to find Tazlak though, one-on-one. Just play it calmly. As Tazlak looking to peek Impress yet again. Gonna go for a bit of a plant there, and Impress switching around for the guns. Tazlak making his way towards CT as Impress approaches the bomb side, and knows what's up. Tasnak just around that left corner. Impress spots him. Impress downs him. Very impressive stuff. Dutch Prodigy, 11-5.
Dutch Prodigy pick up that pistol round. Impress very nicely done by him. Wasn't looking all that likely. The Untouchables looked like they might have some footing back into this to pick up this pistol round, but it doesn't seem like it went their way. And this means that this is just going to be a matter of clutching it out for Dutch Prodigy. They have the riflery in their advantage now. And actually, we see Koze and the Untouchables do the same that we saw Progression do. Was it Progression in the last map? Or was it Lowland Lions, actually? I think it might have been Progression. Either way, this is again that Navi buy-up where you just drop
it's
a rifle.
Lowland Lions.
Okay, fair enough. Lowland Lions. But again, that Navi buy-up, and it seems to be working rather well as they get that first entry. That means another gun in their possession, and they actually have the advantage in terms of riflery now and numbers with people alive. So just play it slowly. No need to push anything quite yet with way more than a minute left on the clock. They can just wait out for Dutch Prodigy to spread their defenses, because they will want all the choke points to be covered. And by the time they're spread out far enough, we'll see the Untouchables moving a bit closer in and actually realize what's lurking over towards that B side, gets taken down by Impress, and that's the cue for the rest to push on.
Yeah, Clash now, the Ump as well. Looking forward to see if he can do something here with this Ump as well. And a couple of flashes coming in, and that really puts Clash to a bit of a hold there. And that bomb has been planted, and it's going to be a 4-4 after plant. Clash now, he's going to have to make his move on this. There's still four more players left up alive, and you need some time to find them as well. There's still two defusers on them as well, so they have got some form of time. Clash does go down to Koze. Koze doing absolute great AK work. The two kills, is it going to be enough? Mikey, not going to be happening. Taslak does take him out, and that's a round for the Untouchables. Not going down in flames just yet.
Well, they had some pretty good weapons in general. Like, the damage that Dutch Prodigy had would have been strong enough, but they didn't have the utility to clear out any of these angles. They had one flashbang that wasn't very effective. No Molotovs, no HEs. They couldn't block off any angles. They couldn't clear them out without having to walk up there, and that did not work out for them. So the Untouchables, they won it in a very nice afterplant situation. And like you say, that means that they're definitely not out yet. They are on the least favored side of this map, but they still have plenty of opportunity to make this happen, as they did just break the economy of Dutch Prodigy.
Yeah, and looks like Mitchell does pick himself up a kill into Koze. Kobus does go down, though. 1-for-1 trade. Still, those upgraded pistols coming into play for Dutch Prodigy. No armor to that name, though, as Mitchell did get tagged up slightly. And now, well, the Untouchables attempting to go towards that A side yet again. They do have still two smokes, a couple of flashbangs up for them to use. There's literally no utility on Dutch Prodigy, and his Maiku now will go down. Impress still on the bomb site will go down quickly afterwards as well. Taslak will down one, but Clash will down Taslak, and there it is. The Untouchables claiming themselves the second round on their T side, 11-7. Getting a little bit closer to Dutch Prodigy, but still a four round lead.
Yeah, and don't forget that Dutch Prodigy is on the most favorite side of this map, despite the fact that the gap in rounds is closing and the Untouchables are getting closer. On paper, this should still be a much easier and very favorable scoreline for Dutch Prodigy, but Taslak does get another early advantage, and Scandalous capitalizes on that, picks up a second one, and Dutch Prodigy just seems to be going down one by one.
This seems to be like very much like the start of Dutch Prodigy on their T side as well. Losing a couple of rounds and then absolutely steamrolling over them. So I'm not sure what their plan is right now, because it is my cue. He does have himself an AK pickup. Should be saving that gun, I'd say. It'd be a nice addition.
It certainly would, because they will be able to buy into the next round. Their round loss bonus is high enough for that, but they will probably be lacking a little bit in terms of utility, and the fact that he can hang on to one rifle, especially because he's one of the members with the lowest money. That means that he can get that extra set of utility that the rest of his teammates might be lacking. And actually, you know, the fact that he gets killed nullifies that just a little bit, so no AK saved, and that means skimping on a little bit of utility, but it looks like here and there they have plenty scraped together.
Yeah, and Clash now having an AWP, which is always good to see on his hands as well. Let's see if he's going to be able to go for a fast peek. Nope, decides to go towards the B-bomb side. Fairbeans does not want to challenge any sort of players. Still all AKs for the Untouchables. That's like not opting to go for that AWP as he will slowly just pre-fire, take some mid control. Mitchell out there in a connector, lurking by. Mike, you're actually just on top of that letter room. Might be able to meet up with Realizer. But Realizer taking it slow and calmly.
Yeah, it's a very calm approach by the Untouchables. Clash, however, got a little bit sick of all that calm and quiet. Goes looking, and actually, I think it was Scandalous who just walked into his pre-aim. Got taken down for it, and Tazlak walks into Mikey just alike, gets taken down as well. Double man advantage for Dutch Prodigy now. Like you said, they start off a little bit shaky, but they manage to stabilize just like they did in the first half. And it's starting to look more and more likely for them to just clutch this out. Good advantage into the round. The bomb is dropped to middle even. I'm not sure if they're defending that actively. I don't think so. But Akid is still a little bit careful picking that up. Does manage to claim it, and at least the T's can try and make something happen now. Looks like the A site is their site of choice so far. They don't really have any smokes to work with, but luckily some flashes to help them get in there. But these two members for the CTs and three more on the potential rotate could make it very difficult for them.
Yeah, and right now the Untouchables, they need an entry, which is not going to happen. Mitchell stops two players in their tracks. AK does down him, but it's a 3-on-1 as MyQ will get spotted and actually down by AK. Impress to find, as well as Clash. That's with an AWP, but Impress cuts down Aked on the cross. Timer's running down as well. Will be 12-8.
Yeah, so Dutch Prodigy, they stabilize, pick up that round. And, well, because of the rounds that the Untouchables managed to pick up and the people that they managed to keep alive in those rounds, mainly the last two, they are able to get somewhat of a buyout. Scandalous, not that rich, still on a PP50, has a little bit of utility around that, but the rest of them seem to be doing quite fine. And Dutch Prodigy is a little bit light on cash themselves, but they are in quite a nice lead, and this should be their opportunity to extend that further.
Yeah, look, I mean,
this. We only got these two members on this B side. First one just got taken down. And
Mike is going to do something good here. I can feel it. I can feel it. This is where Mikey chimes, you know. He's a ninja. Oh god, Mikey, don't make this awkward. Well, there we go. It does take out two kills, but that is going to be it.
Well, two might not have been a hat trick, but it was a nice play by him. And Mitchell able to capitalize on that quite nicely. Picks up one more frag. 2 versus 2 now. Kobus and Mitchell together versus Realizer, who gets taken down by Kobus from short. And all of a sudden, it's just Tazlak left with his AWP, misses that first shot. Bomb is smoked off. He can't actually do anything about this. He has to start spamming through the smoke, does manage, and actually has time to get away. He's dancing around this. Mitchell can't stand it and cannot find that frag either. Tazlak with a very nice clutch does go down, full reset, entire board wiped clean, but another round in the Untouchables' pocket.
That is clutch plays from Tazlak, though, because there was only like 1 second left until the defuse came in. I wasn't really watching the POV, but that's what I can assume.
Yeah, well, as a result, Dutch Prodigy, they won a round, they lose the consecutive one. Their money gets completely reset so far that they don't even bother saving this first round. They have to double eco anyway. They might as well just go for a force up, try and get something out of this. And with the low rifles and SMGs that we have on the Untouchables, that should not be all that much of a stretch, as two frags are exchanged on this B site and a much more of a bloodbath is coming in as Kobus finds another frag with his P250, 2 versus 2.
Yeah, and Clash coming in the back. He has been spotted early on, though. Kobus still in kitchen. Realizer just around that right corner. Scandal is over at the bench. And this could get really tricky here for the Untouchables. They need this round. Kobus landing a couple of attacks. Ooh, Clash can't land it. But now Kobus making it down to a 1-on-1. And ooh, Kobus needs to get away here. Scandal is making his way forward. But Kobus clutches this one out. 13-9. In a round they shouldn't have any right for.
Interesting. Very, very interesting. That Glockfire wasn't very accurate, didn't really do the trick there. And, well, Kobus finally getting an opportunity to shine. He has been relatively quiet throughout this map, and that was a nice way of showing that he is still here. And, like you said, they had no right winning that round. Their economy was broken, and that force was sort of their stay of execution, perhaps. And, well, they made that happen. And instead of stay of execution, it's their lead that they keep expanding. And with the poor money on the Untouchable side, all of a sudden, it looks like Dutch Prodigy might be able to run away with this.
Yeah, and look at his speed of hands from Dutch Prodigy. It seems to be very solid. Seems to be holding very nicely. He's impressed, taking out two players, Mitchell as well. And on the board, the last man is Scandalous. Going to try and plant that bomb. Surely Mitchell's going to be there, spraying through the smoke. That bomb won't get planted, and it will be 14-9. And the Untouchables, their backs against the wall right now, with no money to buy as well.
Yeah, forcing it to that last round was a bit of an interesting choice to make, considering that they didn't really have money to get a proper buy, and they knew that this round would be more important because it's a matter of, you know, being able to still win 16-14 or just having to tie because there's no overtime. So interesting, but either way, doesn't go in their favor. Realizer gets aggressive, picks up the first frag with Kobus, quickly answers with two of his own. And Kose, another deagle shot for him, looking for more.
Yeah, clearly Kobus didn't realize Kose was on top of that A bomb site already. And what a shot from Mitchell. Takes out Kose and absolutely annihilates him. Oh, there we go. Mitchell takes out Taslak as well. It's left up to Akit. Dust picks up the first kill and will down Imprez as well. In just a few seconds, it is Akit to clutch the round.
Okay, so hanging on by the skin of their teeth are the Untouchables, but they do manage to win out that round and prevent Dutch Prodigy from getting onto that irreversible match point that would mean that there's no chance of winning for them anymore. So far, there still is, and the economy just keeps going backwards and forwards. Neither one of these teams has had the opportunity to build up anything of an economy. So again, we see pistols on Dutch Prodigy this time, and AKIT finds the first frag. Clash, however, returns it. Kobus goes pushing, gets taken down, and what a bloodbath.
Oh man. Dutch Prodigy that I'm making really awkward on ourselves by forcing these weird rounds, but who knows? I mean, it did work out a couple of times, so
yeah, that's
can't really just them for that. Scandalous goes down, and that means an AK for Impress. And Mitchell actually picking up a kill for Kose. And now it's a 2-on-2. This could get really awkward for the Untouchables, but AK does take out Mitchell, and there he goes. Flashes out as well, and downing Impress. So AK stepping up to the plate when it's absolutely necessary.
Yeah. Well done by the Untouchables managing to capitalize on that, but like you said, the Dutch Prodigy really has to stop going for these awkward force buys. Just take an eco, take a double eco if you want, although I'm not sure if they'll need that considering the round loss bonus they have built up. But either way, they still have a good advantage, and even if they give up two rounds for free now, their chances of winning the following are rather large, I would say. If they just get an AWP in Clash's hands, everyone else on rifles, they should be fine.
Yeah, look at the aggressive play from Dutch Prodigy. They're trying to make something work with those P250s, but Kobe is now going down to Realizer, and we do have Impress still out there on the window. And Realizer chucks the grenade a little bit too wrong. Impress now firing off a couple of shots, and we'll finally go down to Realizer, and looks like there's not going to be too much damage done, but look at Mitchell just running straight through the smoke as Kose takes him out. Kobus and Kose, it's like tedious.
Yeah, these ecos not really fruitful anymore for Dutch Prodigy. We saw them work out a few times, but it looks like the Untouchables have managed to adjust. The Realizer finally getting some big plays done as well. Picks up four frags there and breaks onto the MVP scoreboard anyway, as he was the only player without one up until that point. You know, little fun random statistic in between. And we do have another buy in Dutch Prodigy, so not going for that double eco. That might have been a little bit too risky for them, considering the rounds that they have already allowed the Untouchables to get. And yeah, the Untouchables just looking to take this A side again. It's been working out very well for them so far. Why wouldn't it again?
Yeah,
because Kobus, that's fine.
Starting up nice. We'll go down though, but did put out a lot of damage, and Again, a lot of damage being done, but no kills, and you need kills right now! Realizer will go down to his teammate. 2-on-3. It's still a possibility. That bomb is gonna go down, though. Just the smoke on the impress. Are they gonna go for it? And I think they should.
To be honest, considering the setup that they have and the lack of a kit, I think saving is better at this point. Because look at how far back Tazlak still is. These two members on the side are going to be able to run down the clock so far.
Right, there it is.
Both of them die, and they don't actually have enough money to do anything with that. So I don't think it was worth pushing into that. And this actually makes this very, very close. This Prodigy, they should be winning this by a landslide. They got 10 rounds on their T side, then go on to the more favored side, the CT side, and continue to pick up 4 rounds. They've managed to get 4 rounds on their T side.
Dutch Prodigy, they really need to start waking up, because this could cost them the Amsterdam Arena, like seriously.
It literally could. And last week we saw a similar situation where they just ended up losing to Triple Play, which wasn't something we expected. And now they're not really, well, doing particularly well against the Untouchables, despite a very good first half. Untouchables again managed to claim this A site. The other two members not even around. Mike Yu has managed to find an AK for himself, so we'll probably be saving that. But I'm not sure if that one AK is going to be doing the trick. Actually, they do have quite a lot of rounds lost in a row, so maybe they will be able to buy when it's 14-14. But even so, they'll have to pick up that round and the next, and then maybe I won't be too disappointed in them. But so far, they've really given the Untouchables far too much space.
Yeah.
Wow. Mike not getting any more space from the Untouchables. You give them your finger and they just take your entire, you know, torso. Okay, everyone dies. Dutch Prodigy wiped off the map, and luckily they do seem to have enough money because of the round loss bonus to get a proper buy-in. Clash does have that op in his hands, and hopefully that's something that can make the difference for them here, as it seems like the Untouchables don't have one, despite having plenty of money to do so, which means that maybe they want to go into something very, very quickly, and I hope that they take a little bit time to analyze the situation before they just go charging in blindly, because that has cost them before, and I wouldn't want them to see screw themselves over after such a nice comeback into this half.
Yeah, like you said, I don't know, like, for some reason, I hope that Untouchables, they win it, but on the other hand, Dutch Prodigy, they've worked hard for it. They did show us a lot of good matches, and, you know, it'd be silly if they lose it.
It would, but that does open a lot of opportunity for MCON and Triple Play. Actually, that would mean that Triple Play is most likely to go to the arena, I think, because they are still in fourth place. So that's very, very interesting. But we're nearing the 1 minute mark on this round, and no frags have happened yet. Everyone for the T's rather, is closing in on this A site, and Realizer goes to the peak, gets taken down by Clash.
Yeah, finally Clash with an ADLP, because he strikes back with the frag of the Mitchell, and Mikey still just below that dark spot. Oh man, Mike, you're going down to Scandalous, and could this be it for the Untouchables? As they drop another three players, it's Impress, your last man standing, it's not gonna happen!
This is the most important game for Dutch Prodigy to win, especially after their underperformance last week when they lost the Triple Play, and for the Untouchables, it literally does not matter what happens here, because it's impossible for them to qualify anyway. And what are we seeing? The Untouchables just got their match point over Dutch Prodigy, despite being 10-5 behind at halftime. This is absolutely ridiculous. Dutch Prodigy, what are you doing? You're making me think of Astralis. It's a choking reference.
Dutch Prodigy just lost their spot.
They did, because even if they tie, they're not going to have enough points. So, to be honest, this game is already over, despite Clash acing this round. And unfortunately, I think they know that. So I think that the way they're going to be approaching this round is already with a lot of frustration. That can either be good or bad in terms of how it will turn out for them. But it looks like Dutch Prodigy is not going to be the team to get into the Amsterdam Arena, to get that fourth spot, that fourth seed, to go up against Lowland Lions in the first match. But instead, it's going to be either Triple Play or MCON, depending on who wins the next map. So that is interesting. I'm glad that everything's been excited until the end. And Tazlak keeps it exciting as well as he gets taken down by Clash, but Scandalous is there for the return. And ironically, Dutch Prodigy do have the man advantage going into the remainder of this round.
Well, 3-on-3. The Dutch Prodigy still have something to fight back with. Impress does. Oh man, Mike, you just getting obliterated. It's Mitchell, your last man standing. Footy on her. Oh. Oh man. It feels so bad for Dutch Prodigy. He had all the chances in the world. But now, it actually means that triple play and MCOM could be a good match.
Yeah, the winner of that match is going to the arena.